Hi friends, right now I am holding an AC voltage controller in my hands. It is a general purpose AC controller and it can be used to control the speed of single phase AC motors. It can also be used as a dimmer to control light of high power lights, and you can even control heating power of heating elements with this controller. The connections are very simple. This one is the common pin here, this one is the output and input here. Let's first connect the common wires here. Basically, I have connected both neutral wires with this point, and now I will connect the load side first, which is the bulb here, and finally this is the live wire. Of course, I have not connected it to the mains yet, and let me insert this wire here and tighten the screw. I'm now going to turn it on, but before that, please click on the subscribe button if you have not already done so. I will now slowly increase the voltage here, which should control the light of this bulb. As you can see, the light of this bulb is increasing. It is full now, and now I am decreasing the light. And here it is almost turned off now. Let's attach something bigger with this controller and see if it can handle it. I will slowly turn the knob. There it goes. As you can see, I can increase the speed of this cylinder here. It is full now. So increase the speed. It is getting slower and slower. Finally, it is now time to see what's inside this controller. I will now tear it open and I will show you the internal components. Let me open it here. The body is made of aluminium and only two screws are holding it together. So hopefully it should be easier to open it. The upper portion is slidable and very easy to remove. There is 500k and 2 watt variable resistance side, which is there to adjust the voltage, and again there are 2 screws to hold the internal circuit inside. This one is there to hold the PCB, and this one is there to hold the thyristor with the heatsink plate to transfer the heat. Honestly speaking, I was expecting something bigger inside this controller, but it is much simpler than I expected. You can see a bridge rectifier here to turn the AC into DC. You can see 2 resistors, a capacitor, 0.15 microfarad, and this capacitor is it is 0.01 farad, and these 2 resistors, there are 33k each. The left resistor is probably there as a fuse. Let's have a look at the main thyristor here. It is a PTA 100-800. Wow, that's much better than I expected. It can handle around 100 amps of current at much more than 220 volts. So this provided that these connectors and this PCB can handle 10,000 watts, I think this thyristor can easily handle the load. Well friends, that's the end of my video. If you like my video, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel and click on the bell icon for more similar and interesting videos, and please share my video with your friends. And if you have any question, please comment in the comment section below.